We are tracking today. Tripura Chief Minister Biplab Deb has stoked a controversy once again with his latest remark. While addressing civil servants, the Tripura Chief Minister told the officials not to fear contempt of court orders. He said that while it's the court's duty to pass orders, it's the police that will implement them, and the police force comes under him. He also called himself a tiger. TMC condemned Deb's remarks, accusing him of mocking the judiciary and taking to Twitter. TMC MP Abhishek Banerjee said that Biplab Kumar Deb is a disgrace to the entire nation.
আমি আপনাদেরকে বলি এগুলো না করা আমার সঙ্গে স্যার এটা সিস্টেম এর মধ্যে অসুবিধা দেব কাইসে অসুবিধা দেব স্যার এটা রিস্ট্রিক্ট করতে পারতাম না কোর্টে কন্টেম্পট হয়ে যাবগা কোর্টে কন্টেম্পট কে যে কে কে জেলে গেছে তো বড় আমি আসি তো আপনারা গেলে আমি আগে যাব এত সুন্দর না জেলে লয়ে যাব জেলে নেওয়ার জন্য পুলিশ চাই পুলিশ কিন্তু মুখ্যমন্ত্রী তার
उधर का चीफ मिनिस्टर बोलता है कोर्ट क्या करेगा हम ही पूरा पूरी सब है हम जो करेगा कोर्ट वही करेगा हम किसी को नहीं मानता वो वीडियो मेरे को पास आए हुए है मैं भी सबको दे दूंगा अगर एनीबॉडी इज इंटरेस्टेड तो है आई कैन गिव इट एनीबॉडी कैन गो फॉर डिफॉर्मेशन अगेंस्ट ऑफ यू एज ए चीफ मिनिस्टर वॉट एवर यू हैव सेड इट इज टू मच इट इज ए डिवास्टेशन स्पेशली फ्रॉम द जस्टिस लीगल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू हम कोई कानून के हम आलोचना कर सकते हैं कोई जजमेंट में हम डिस्कशन करते हैं जस्टिस के नहीं लेकिन हम जजमेंट को कर सकते हैं ये हमारा कानूनी हक है लेकिन हम ही सब है और कौन कुछ नहीं है सबको चैलेंज करते हैं
देखो विचार व्यवस्था बीजेपी राज्य मुख्यमंत्री বিচার ব্যবস্থা নিয়ে ঠাট্টা করছে বলছে কন্টেম্পট অফ কোর্ট এলো কি গেল আমার যায় আসে না আর সেখানে বিচার ব্যবস্থা কেন সুমো মতো কমিউনিকেশন দেবে না কিসের ভয় আইনের ঊর্ধ্বে তো কেউ নয় সে প্রধানমন্ত্রী হোক আর মুখ্যমন্ত্রী হোক বা আমি হই বা আপনি হোক ভারতবর্ষে আইনের শাসন চালাতে হবে শাসনের আইন চলবে না
আই হ্যাভ মিস্টার টিএন Vanilla Yagam, retired Madras High Court judge, and Ramakant Gaur, lawyer, joining me. Good afternoon, gentlemen. Thanks for joining us. Coming to you first, Mr. Gaur. How do you look at this? Is this political arrogance? You know, talking about some sort of a fiefdom that the chief minister has over the police force, and nothing can deter, the office, the ministers working under him, from defying contempt of court orders, because that is what is being suggested here. Literally a call to defy contempt of court orders because after all without the police force intervention nothing can happen.
This appears to be stupidity in my point of view. The chief minister forgot that he took oath of this office by sticking to the provisions of the Constitution of India. Probably he doesn't know that Article 141 of the Constitution of India says that the law of this country is what is held by the apex court. The law of this country is interpreted by the courts. If the courts are defied in this brazen manner, then where is the rule of law? What law is he talking about? Is it a jungle raj? I mean, this is something which is shameless. This is something which is not palatable and he must be taken care of by the courts of this country. If the chief minister of state says this...
Yes, absolutely, because this is an address made to the civil servants, Mr. Gaur. Yes, and it sends an extremely wrong message, like you rightly pointed out. This also, as Mr. Gaur said, is somewhere out of line with the oath of office that a chief minister undertakes to respect the law of the land. And in that respect, therefore, we must, question Mr. Vali Nayagam, that how is it that a person holding a constitutional position is making a statement like this and almost getting away with it because we are not hearing anyone in the BJP leadership, for instance, condemning this or calling out the chief minister, what do you expect should be done immediately to deter, you know, other CMs or other ministers from thinking along these lines?
Yeah, see, firstly, his very statement is contempt of court. Under the Contempt of Courts Act, anybody who interferes with administrative justice is punishable. Therefore, somebody from your media should file a petition before the Supreme Court to prosecute you for contempt and hold you for contempt and punish him. This is the law of the land. Number two, see, suppose if he says don't obey, that again amounts to what you call under section 108 IPC, inducing to commit an offense. And when he addresses a meeting to civil servants, then he is also calling upon them not to obey the orders of the court. If the orders of the court is not obeyed, what will happen to the country? See, after all, judiciary, executive and legislative are most important things. Now, legislative makes a law, judiciary says the law is right or wrong, and it is the duty of the executive to execute the order of the Supreme Court. Suppose tomorrow, let us take it for the purpose of argument. Suppose somebody wants to, commit a murder or commit some plot to kill the chief minister himself. And the court comes and says, no, that fellow should be punished. And the executive should carry out the order. Now the chief minister will say, no, don't execute the order. Will he say that? Yeah, after all, it is nothing but human arrogance. It is a legal arrogance. And
Absolute arrogance, because as we all know, legislation, executive, judiciary, and of course the media are four pillars of democracy. And here you have Mr. Biplab Deb literally wishing away the entire judiciary, because what he's saying essentially that yes, the court may pass orders, but who will enforce those orders? Police will, and police is under me. Now, Mr. Gaur, do you see this also as, in some ways, something that's been happening in this country in some way or the other? And Mr. Deb is only articulating it, because it is true in one way that, of course, it is the duty of the state government when it comes to law enforcement or law and order for that matter. And if there is a law of the land, enforcing does come under the jurisdiction of the CM. Of course, he's talking about a blatant misuse here. But the fact of the matter is he articulating a pattern that's happening in this country?
Madam, see, the point is, somebody should initiate an action. Nobody will take action suo motu by the court. There are only two ways to initiate action. One by a person affected, or by a PIL, or by initiation of suo motu by the court itself. Now, as media women or as your mirror, you can tomorrow, you need not even go to the court. You send a petition on email to the court and say, please issue summons, take it as a contempt of court and punish him. The Supreme Court must take the thing into consideration. So these people should not be allowed even to rule one day. Say, for example, suppose central ministers are arrested in Maharashtra and other places. The question is whether a minister can be arrested. Suppose tomorrow that man commits some crime and he is to be arrested. Can he say, no, don't arrest me, then magistrate order, don't obey? It is not a question of, Supreme is a court, every court is a court by itself, and the contempt against every court is a contempt under the Contempt of Courts Act. But the power of punishment compact is given to the High Court and Supreme Court. Now, anybody disobeys the Contempt of Court Act definitely should be punished and should be brought to trial. There's no two opinion about that.
Yes, absolutely. In that case, the Tripura CM is literally misleading people, making people believe as if the CM is the ultimate authority in this. But as we just heard Mr. T.N. Valinayagam clarifying that there is no choice. When there is a court order, it has to be enforced. There cannot be a case where a chief minister can say that, no, I will not follow the court orders. That does not happen, which is why, again, this is extremely important to highlight here, that for a man who's holding a constitutional position of the chief minister of a state to make this irresponsible statement, which is extremely misleading from what we understand, is, of course, unacceptable. But then let's not forget that here is a chief minister who's lost his credibility a number of times because of making a certain controversial statements. He's the same man who said internet existed in the Mahabharat era, and following that, of course, a couple of other controversial statements as well, which of course cannot be substantiated with facts. We leave it at that. T.N. Valinayagam and Ramakant Gaur, thanks for joining us. Let's take a short break here. News and updates continue on the other side. Stay with us.